Hey there, learners! Welcome to another exciting lesson on how to take a snapshot in CLO 3D 5.1. You might also know it as a screenshot, but it's much more than that. Are you ready to learn something new? Let me show you our working file. Before taking a screenshot, I have added some style to this garment with my style line. If you are wondering how to do that, you can check out this class of ours. You can find the link in our description. But don't worry if you don't want to do that right now, because you can still take a snapshot without it. It's just an extra feature that you can use to make your design more attractive. To take your screenshot, you have to go to File, then select Snapshot from there. Here, you have two options, 2D and 3D. So choose the one that you want a snapshot of and follow me along. For now, I am going to pick 3D because I want to show you that part. After selecting the option that you want, you will be asked to save your file. Give it a name and location that you like. As I told you, this is not just a regular snapshot, but it's something more awesome. Here, you can take multiple shots with one click too. How cool is that? So, pick the option from here that suits your need. After this, you can set your view from the default option or by using the camera icon that's available at the bottom of each image. Next, we have the property of each image. You can even select the presets of your image to adjust its size. Next to this, we have orientation. So, you can set horizontal or vertical view of the image. After this, you have the size of the file in terms of pixels. So, higher the value will make your image sharper, but also, don't make it too high that it takes forever to load. Next, we have view count, where you can save from 2 to 8 images of your product. I think 4 images are enough for me, so I will leave it at that. Below this, we have layout, where horizontal and vertical are usual ones, but box is something different. So, let's try it out. This way, our image will be arranged in a nice way. So, now our two images are on the top and two are on the bottom. I think this looks good. So, I will keep it like this. Next, we have three more options from which the first one is to make our background transparent. This can be useful if you want to edit your image later on. After this, we have Save Separate Images. It means that if we don't want to keep this ticked, we will only get this big images with all four views as one image. But I want individual image of each view, so I will keep this ticked as well. Our last option is Extract All Colorways. This is for when you have created different colorways or patterns for the same design and want their snapshots as well as this one. But we don't have any colorways right now, so I will leave it as it is. Press OK and voila! Here is our result. 4 separate images of each view and 1 collage with all 4 images, as I told you. Isn't that amazing? This is all about snapshot. With this feature, you can easily share your ideas with others in a snap and get feedback or approval of your design for further production. I hope this was helpful and fun for you. And if it was, then please like our video and hit our subscribe button. That will motivate us to keep making more informative and enjoyable videos for you like this one. If you have any suggestion for our next video, please let us know in the comment box below. Until then, keep learning and creating. See you next time.